you're so excited. You know what I've been. I try, but I can't fight it. It's real. You're making it hard for me. Not when you shake it like that, that, that. I see that you like it like that. Shake it like that. I see that.
Oh. Hold on, Vaughn. Let's see what he got to say. Give me 1 second.
All right. Only one. Yeah, my wifey. Made my life a pretty sweet. Oh, God.
Favorite sister.
How are you?
What's up, Maddie? Tell that man I ain't got nothing but love. Always had nothing but love for you. We ain't even never had an argument in life.
Ever. How are you?
I'm fine. You know, one thing I don't like to do is I don't like to text because it's very disingenuous. Mm-hmm. Like, it's easy to look at a text and based on your own perception, it could be vicious or it could be like, you know, it's subjective. So text is always tricky. But what I was saying about, because you made a couple good points. When bro was saying how he just don't want to have multiple like baby mothers and stuff like that. Uh-huh. That's a great point because in the society that we in right now, uh-huh. I don't know if it would particularly benefit us. You know what I'm saying? To have, hold on real quick. If it would particularly benefit us to have multiple partners when in just dealing with, sometimes in just dealing with one person, it's hard enough to establish a real true bond because we still learning who we are. So what I've been getting killed for lately, and I'm willing to go out, you already know how I am, is what relationships really are. And I know as being a woman and being a strong ass black woman, mm-hmm. you got your idea, you know, but here's what I would say. If you were buying a car, would you want to buy a car from a person who had cars that was working or cars that was broken and needed to be fixed? What would you choose?
Broken and need to be fixed.
All right, so that shows kind of where you gauge things because you like to build, right? Mm-hmm. So you'll take something, you'll put the reparation. But here's the problem. We are broken and need to be fixed. So when you join someone else who's broken and needs to be fixed, sometimes we gauge it from the perspective of, oh, I can just help this person. But can't nobody help anybody but themselves?
He just said, so you can't restore something to be great?
Yeah, but you have to restore yourself to be great. So my whole point is about you can't restore people. People can only restore themselves. Right. And you can assist them. You can aid them. You can be the accessory. You can inspire them. You can motivate them. And you can do the opposite. You can piss them off. You can run them away. You can break them down. You can make them feel like shit. Okay? And the only thing that can build that person up in any of those instances is what they're willing to do for self. Because let's say you're my girl, Maddie, in this scenario. And we're happy. You are giving me happiness and you are helping me. I'm broken. You fixing me, right? Mm-hmm. When you decide that now I'm a burden to you in your own journey, because I'm in maybe 5, 6, 7 years where people don't take this into accountability. 7 years down the line. Mm-hmm. You like, Los, I love you. I mean, I do love you. I need something. Now I'm trying to spread my wings further than what I got going on. And I'm just saying, it's not that I don't love you, but I need room to grow. Okay? What happens is, my perfect scenario and what I've learned, because I have something that's working, so not broken. I got over 13 years working.
Mm-hmm.
Super good. Not even on a brink, on an edge, sketchy, nothing. It's running. It's up and running. It took work throughout all those years. But here's the thing, what I learned in my older age. We're not in ownership of one another. Maddie is going to have aspirations. She's going to have desires. She's going to have dreams. She's going to have things.
Hello.
Yeah, your phone was ringing or something.
Can you hear me?
I hear you now. Yes, I hear you.
Okay.
So you're gonna have things that are outside of my understanding, beyond my experience sometimes, because you're a woman. You have certain innovative things within you that, let's be honest, since the beginning of time, we can't act like men have fully understood women, and we figured it women out. Women are so dynamic, so diverse. So complex. A woman is so complex. Niggas ain't figured they woman out. And the only way you can figure anything out is to let it be what it is.
Mm-hmm.
You feel me? And I feel like a lot of these men right now, like the girl started the OnlyFans. So you seen the thing going viral, right? The girl started the OnlyFans and the dude broke up with her?
Uh-huh.
You saw that, right?
It's no. Love okay, is not so- possessive, and I feel that's the issue.
Yes, love is, and true love is not possessive. True love is the love for self, right? And I'm going to get to that. So the girl did an OnlyFans and the dude broke up with her, so she was mad. And she
that was
like,
real? I thought that was when they were in the bathroom or something?
Yeah. But here's the thing. Whether it's real or not, it's real. It exists. We know this is something that happens. So mm-hmm. If it wasn't real in that case, they were making fun of something that happens. Girls with these OnlyFans and how people view it now. Here's my thing. She said to him, are you going to pay my bills?
I saw that one. Yeah.
Right? Nobody's addressing that. Nobody's addressing the fact that she said, nigga, if you want me to alter something on my side of the spectrum, where are you creating room for the shift?
Right.
So everybody's making it seem like, oh, she got an OnlyFans. Fam. Again, it's his fear. Because put it like this. You could work at a strip club. You could be a prostitute. You could be a porn star.
Mm-hmm.
And all them got boyfriends. We ain't going to act like they some lonely women. They got boyfriends. I'm talking about relationships, right?
Mm-hmm.
So if you doing the OnlyFans, what's your biggest fear in a woman? Oh, independence? The fact that now she going to get this bread, bro, and she ain't going to have to ask you for shit? She ain't got to divvy this up with 50 other girls at the fucking club and some weird ass promoter nigga. Like, she's in her room doing her shit, getting her own bands. And now you fear that she'll grow past you. She'll grow past what you can provide. There's a fear there.
With that, I should say the
or
fear.
Or are you fearful? Let me ask you one more question. Or is he fearful that the world will see her poom poom or see her booty or see her titties? Because, nigga, that's all you see anyway. That's right. Normality. A girl could get on OnlyFans, put on a little dress, and wiggle her ass, and niggas would pay for it. So what is your fear, bro? What's your real fear? We got to think about this. I got one of the most beautiful girls.
Mm-hmm.
All right? I had her when I have a penny in my pocket. She's riding around in Bentleys and shit. At some point, you have to be secure when that woman walk out the door. You know what's out this door? Especially in where I live, you know what's out this door? The bags, the monies, the niggas, they out there. I'm talking about they handsome, they got money, they taller than a motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? All the shit that would intimidate certain people. So it's like, yo, you got to just be confident. And where does that come from? That comes from self.
Mm-hmm.
I got to be confident. So how am I going to have Maddie and be in a relationship with Maddie if I ain't confident? all that ass walking out the door. Every time I turn around, she's on IG. She's making a living off of her aesthetic. She's making a living off of her aesthetic, being beautiful. Okay, she's a modern day, you know, model in many different facets. She's a brand ambassador. She's out there. She's in the arena of being social. If you're an insecure nigga, that relationship is not going to work. So it has absolutely nothing to do with what you do, but with what I do as a man. Every time your phone bling, am I trying to look to see if it's an NBA nigga or something? That's weak. And a lot of niggas have gotten soft over the years from their mamas and from their aunties and everybody pampering them and not have enough men in the black household to create that structure where we understand, yo, a woman want to be sexy. Like I was just telling my girl, like, women are damn near naked all the time. I think they just want to be nude. I don't feel like it's promiscuous or provocative. I feel like it's expressive. It's art and it's deep. I don't think it's, I know we ain't there yet, but as a culture, I just feel like it's art. I feel like it's Africa.
It's like people come at me like, oh, you're in bikinis on your page. And I'm like, I'm on vacation. And all the, like, what is it? Why is it affecting you? What is it? What am I doing wrong?
The insecurities of those women who maybe feel like they can't reveal themselves from either being hindered by a man or maybe they don't got the voluptuous things popping. And everybody needs to get into their own shit. Because tall women that skinny like a pencil, you bad as hell. Women with all the curves, you bad as hell. Light skin, dark skin, skinny, fat, whatever, you bad as hell as long as you walk out that door and you know you.
Mm-hmm.
So here we go again.
It's self-love, confidence.
Self-love. But... and guess what rules relationships? Self-love. Not jealousy, not fear, not insecurity, but self-love. And my idea of a relationship, because I don't think relationships are real. I think boyfriend, girlfriend, I think all those are like titles and constructs that have precepts of like what we can and can't do based on one another. So say, for instance, I look at a girl's ass while we walking and you like, hey, yo, nigga, you going to disrespect me? And I'm like, oh, damn, my bad. I thought she looked nice. I'm being honest. I didn't mean nothing. I just thought she looked nice. And you like, nah, nigga, that's disrespectful, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now let's switch the whole scenario. Girl walking down the street, I'm holding your hand. We both look at her ass and you like, damn, bitch, she had a nice ass. The only thing that changed the scenario was whether or not you liked the ass. Because in one scenario, when you didn't like it, now it's disrespect. So I have to alter who I am based on who I'm with. And I don't think that's real. I think that's why the divorce rate is out of here. Why niggas is always breaking up. Girls, why we always breaking up, fussing, fighting. You know, why Drake got so many damn songs is because people are living through other people's insecurities. And the moment you get to be free, the moment you get to be Maddie and go on vacations and put on your bikini and run through the sand and get in the water and just breathe, you're going to like that freedom more than you like being in bondage with some person. And the same for men and women, because women be putting niggas in a box of what they like and what they don't like. And I just think all that shit is fake. And if you really want to have a long relationship, look at Will and Jada, look at Jay-Z and Beyonce, everybody talking about what happened, but did they break up?
A lot of relationships these days fail because of social media. Fail because, oh, you know, why is my nigga, why are you following this girl? Why are you liking her pictures? And I can honestly say I'm one of them. I'm that girl. I will get upset, like, what are you following this girl for? Why are you liking her pictures? Right. And then it's not that I'm insecure, it's more so, what are you looking for?
Can I ask you a question?
What?
Do you feel like that's something you need to grow past as a woman? Let's just be honest. Huh?
Eventually, but I just don't see the sense of it.
Maddie, listen. We're not talking about, because you're going to put your perception on it and that's going to switch it. It's going to change it. I just want to know, when you think just as a human being, I'm monitoring what this nigga gets to like. Is that a bit possessive?
Okay, hold on. Before I get there.
You want to save it.
No. There's a difference. If your man, like, if my man is liking photos with women half naked, that's not okay.
Maddie, you do not have on clothes in your pictures. That is hypocritical.
What do you mean?
Let me tell you what I mean. Let me tell you what I mean. We're talking to big 13 years right here. 13 years strong. Strong, okay? No issues in the house. House is beautiful. Shit is lovely. Let me tell you how to get like this, okay? If my girlfriend is Maddie, again, I'm going to keep putting you in a scenario, and her pictures are half naked on Instagram, and she's my girlfriend, it stands to reason I like half naked women on Instagram. Because what represents me as my woman and my lady is half naked. It would be hypocritical and weird if I didn't like that, but I liked it only in my woman and I didn't like it. That would be false. It would be a false thing. And so here's the thing. If I like you and you're my woman and we're secure in that, and we have that union, that agreement, I should be able to like all other women in that aspect, because you should understand that I don't share that relationship with them. I share it with you, but this has to be what I like because it's why I picked you.
But listen, but say for instance, this person did not know about your Instagram via, you know, prior to meeting you.
How the fuck is that your girl then? If it's something you don't know about your own girl, then you are making the scenario.
No, the person obviously knows my Instagram now. I'm speaking in general, by the way, guys.
Because this is what the person likes. That's what I'm telling you. That means you never knew what the person liked. And now you need to learn what the person likes. And if you see your man liking something, what you should do is not attack it. You should pay attention to it and give him what he likes. Give him what he likes. He likes that, you do that, you be that. Just give the person what they likes. Like if every time we go in the store, you say, damn, baby, that's a cute bag. Or that's a cute little doggy. They're so cute. I need to take the hint that you probably like cute ass little doggies in nice little bags. And if one day I just surprise you with that, you'd be like, oh my God, babe, I can't believe this. We spend too much time trying to put somebody in a box and not live outside the box with them. Have fun with them. Niggas is in their 20s and 30s and living like they in their 70s and 80s. This shit is whack. The relationships ain't gonna last. They ain't gonna last. It won't matter. You'll be an ex. You'll be an ex of a person. It won't fucking last. Because guess what? There's a girl who ain't insecure about that shit out there. And they'll find each other and they'll link up, because that's how energy works. It's about energy.
But listen, I understand what you're saying. I kind of agree with you, but then I don't, because when he's liking those photos, when you guys are liking these pictures, that woman, especially when it's more than one, that woman is thinking otherwise.
So what? When you posting a picture, now when she slides, your ass out, niggas is thinking otherwise. You're fulfilling niggas' fantasies. But at the end of the day, you ain't fulfilling niggas' fantasies. It's a double-edged sword. You are fulfilling their fantasies visual, because this world is visual. If I see something that visually stimulates me, I can't control the way my body react. I don't have to say, hey, penis, get hard. There's a big fat ass naked. It's called nature. And since we was all supposed to be naked anyway, God ain't create clothes. This is a man-made construct because of shame, because of fear. We don't even live in our natural state. So you're promoting to be unnatural while you getting your whole natural ass off on the ground. It's a contradiction, Maddie. And as your big brother, I'm going to tell you that when you start to get out of that mindset, whatever relationship you are in with a man, because you're a great woman, it's going to be even better, and you won't have those hiccups, because you're creating those, you're projecting those insecurities onto the dude. Just like, let him like the art that he likes. Women are art. Let him like that. Women are curvy for a reason, because that shit is art. You know what I'm saying? I like to say, I got one song where I say, women are curvy because that was God writing in cursive. You know what I'm saying? And that's what I think. So we got to let that be that. You got to let that be that. And be strong. The stronger a woman is, the more secure her man is. The stronger a man is, the more secure his woman is. Yo, I be in here in my slippers, and my girl could go to the fucking ballers and whatever cookout party, and I'm in this bitch in my slippers, my nigga. I'm playing 2K, and I'm not tripping off shit in life, okay? Nothing. But guess what? I had, like you said, I wasn't always vegan, right? You said that. Mm-hmm. In the times that I've been vegan for 6 years, almost 7 years now, 6 years, right? I turned vegan when I went 30, when I went vegan when I turned 33, all right? Yo, listen. I've grown more in the last 6 years of my life than I've grown in my entire life put together. And I got some experiences under my belt. I've grown more in the last 6 years from just having clairvoyance, just having a clear mind, a clear cognitive, just my brain, just my mind, my focus. I'm more successful, more understanding. And what I had to tell myself, even in my own relationship at one point, was this. You know what? Because my girl felt that like that way at one point. Who's these girls? Who? It could have been you, Maddie, right? You could have left me a message like, damn, Los, what's up? You don't even holler at a bitch, or you don't even holler at your sis no more. You could have said anything, right? Mm-hmm. And to a woman that's insecure in that way, she would look at that and then look at your page and really be like, oh, who is this bitch? Because you know you've been who's this bitch to a lot of niggas' women, right?
I'm sure.
Okay, so let's not even fake the phone. And you ain't that bitch. You just, oh, you're a woman. You know, people don't know you. They don't know your personality. They don't know how you such like a, you know, not to, nobody take this the wrong way, but you like one of the guys. They don't know, you know what I'm saying? You ain't all sitting up trying to have somebody just look at you. You no. just want, you wear sneakers. You thorough. Like people don't, so that's what I'm saying. While we projecting these fears and these insecurities, it ain't even that deep. It don't be that deep. But you know what will happen? Somebody will run somebody into the arms of a Maddie, because you'll look at that, be like, damn, what is you doing? And you'll look at Maddie like, and she mad cool. She could just chill. That's what you would want. You would eventually stop wanting the thing that you think looks so perfect and whatever. And you start wanting the thing that feels better. You know, we don't want what's good for us. We,
right.
we need to get what feels better. And that's what, so why I do agree with the young man for not having multiple baby mamas, and I made my comment, you would have to be on a high spiritual path to have multiple seeds spread it throughout this earth, because the things that you would have to instill in your family and that whole structure would have to be on a whole nother level, because we not there yet. We just not there. It's too much turmoil. So to have my kid not vegan at this point of my life, the kid would suffer so much because of we're neurologically affected by the foods we eat. So while my son is growing up and he's already dealing with this crazy ass world, COVID-19, all this shit, we're dealing with this shit. While my child is dealing with this, I don't need to have things inside of his body that host insecurities. Because then we got to get to, well, why does Maddie really have these things she feels and so deeply? And we learn that food is synonymous with emotions. The foods we eat are synonymous with the emotions we go through. That's why we nickname our foods emotions. Like something tastes salty, but we call when somebody act mad weird, salty. And somebody that's jealous, we call them bitter. But somebody that's nice, we call them sweet. Or if you give me a kiss, I call it sugar. And then we got to look at the correlations, the correspondence between those words. And when you need love, when you need sex, when you ain't had it, What do you tend to do? You eat a lot of sugar. You tend to eat a lot of sugar. So we're compensating for things when we get into biochemistry in our bodies that we don't have. So when you eat certain shit, your brain don't know the difference between milk, whole milk, and crack cocaine. Your brain can't distinguish the difference because they both do the same thing in the human brain.
All right.
So when a person gets around you and they're bitter, let's say you got three girls around you that's bitter. You can get high blood pressure from bitter people, the same way you get high blood pressure from too much bitter food. Whole facts. You eat too much salt right now. Doctor gonna say, hey, you got high blood pressure. You be around too many salty bitches right now. They will run your whole blood pressure up. It's a fact. So there's a correlation. So the reason why I can't deal with a girl that's not vegan and bear a child with her is because I'm not trying to create my child to have all these external emotions going on, and I have to deal with them from within. And we already got too much shit off right now. We already, like, as a society, we're behind everybody. We're emotional as fuck. A black man get killed, we don't even know what to do as a society, as a culture.
Mm-hmm.
We don't know what to do together. We have no collectiveness. So at this point in my life, where I'm at in my journey, I just wouldn't procreate with a woman that I already took a journey with another woman. We already went through that whole journey and made it there. I wouldn't go back. Just like at this point, Maddie, you wouldn't have a child with a broke nigga. I'm just saying, if you made it to this point and you made it to a certain level of men that you deal with, that's your standard and you ain't going back. Period. Right. So that's just what it is, because it would hinder your child too much at this point for you to have create with somebody that can't provide on a level that you know you and your kid need. It would just be foolish. And I feel like that's a real thing. I don't feel like that's superficial. That's a real thing. If a nigga ain't got it on that level what you needed, why would you go backwards? That's crazy.
Okay, I need you to help me understand. I just want to get a better understanding. So, you know, when we hang up this call, I can have something to think about.
You got shit to
do. We're going to rewind to the part where you said, Lo, at one point, she was insecure about your the whole Instagram thing, why you said that, right?
Yeah.
How did you get her to be secure?
I didn't, because I can't get nobody to be secure. So what I did was I started to secure myself. I started to secure myself. So how I secured myself was I said, you know what? Because insecurity is contagious. Mm-hmm. It's contagious. When somebody always insecure, it make you like, damn, why you like that? The fuck? What you got going on? You know, it's low frequency is very contagious.
Correct.
Like an attitude creates an attitude. If I called you right now and I had a fucking attitude, you'd be like, nigga, what the fuck you got an attitude for, nigga? Mm-hmm. You instantly got an attitude and you ain't do shit to have an attitude.
Right.
So what I did was I said, you know what? Let me just elevate myself, because everybody's on their journey. And this is what I mean by not owning people. Everybody's on their fucking journey. And wherever they are, they are. And you can't just fast forward a motherfucker. Understand me. Fast forward. That's not life. That's not nature. So I said, you know what? I'm going to elevate myself. And how I elevated myself was, I had a talk one day. I said, you know what I'm going to do from now on? I'm only going to focus on the things that I love. That's it. I don't give a fuck how much I hate something. I'm not going to give it no energy. I'm not going to focus on it until I can erase it. I'm only going to focus on the shit that I love. And then day by day went by, and then I started to, like, she'll come downstairs or some shit, and I'd just be like, look at her, smile, and be like, damn. And it really started to manifest. Like, damn, this is what I miss. This is what I love. Like, not so manually and mechanically, but just naturally, like, she walking in the kitchen, I ain't paying me no mind. I'm just like, damn. Because I changed my mindset. I'm only going to focus on the things I love. I don't give a fuck your phone ring. If your phone ring and you walk out the room, I'm like, why you walk out the room? Come on, that's some weak shit. It's like, I don't give a fuck. I love the fact that you with me. That's good enough. I love that. And you got to start doing that. And you got to put yourself in that perspective. And once you do that, if you're not with the person no more, you're not supposed to be. Because if you change somebody, that's not good work. If you change yourself, that's great work. And if they change themselves, that's great work. But if you change a nigga, that means he never had the power to change himself. And what woman needs a man like that?
You talking. You talking.
Yeah, because you know me, man. I'm in the cut. I've been quarantined for the last 6 years. I don't even come outside. I come out every once in a while. I see you. We hug, say what's up, hey, man, or whatever. But I don't even come outside like that. You don't see me at penthouse. You don't see me. I don't even go to
forever.
But when I see you, it's love, and you know,
always.
But when you know, I don't come out much, and that ain't because nobody insecure or nothing. Like, we good. I have no desire to be out. And if I have a desire, then I'll have that desire. I don't go to strip clubs. But if I have a desire, if any day it comes, and I'll go. And I'll be proud and not trying to hide. And, you know, I noticed, like, the times when, you know, say I could have seen you, hugged you, and somebody would take a fucking picture.
Right.
Send it to her. Look at him. That would be a whole fucking thing. So
times absolutely when nothing.
A whole thing. And it's like nothing of the nothings. It's the most nothing of nothing. And so I felt like at times when I was trying to mash shit, or maybe I just didn't want to say this because I didn't want this result. It just was worse. And it's just like, you know what, my nigga? I'm a social person. People love me. I attract people. People attract me. I'm an energy dude. I'm Aries. Like, this is me. This is who I am. I can't run around faking like that. If it ain't like that, it ain't like that. And it's just got to be like that.
You're a very genuine person. Very, very.
I've learned to be over the years way more genuine than I've ever been, because sometimes.
When I met you were genuine.
Well, what I'm saying is I've learned. Well, we didn't have a relationship. So it's easier to be genuine. But it's easier to be genuine to a person that you don't feel like, you know, that you have a relationship with. It's like, oh, I could talk to my friend. I could talk to my homegirl about this, but I could never talk to my girl about this. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So it's like, I learned to be way more genuine now than I've ever been, just by having knowledge of self and understanding who I am and being okay with that. And then out of nowhere, my girl just took this whole spiritual journey. I'm talking about, man, she's into her whole energy crystals and, man, her moon cycles. And like, out of nowhere, now she's this person way deeper than me into all the whole shit, like deep. You know, she's born in Africa. She got a whole heritage of things that she could be focusing on, and not social media, not, you know, Instagram or like that shit. What is that? That shit is like, nigga, if you ain't using that shit to promote and get some money, what is we even talking about? We really talking about randoms on the gram? Like that's not even a thing. For people to make that a thing, you don't have a real relationship if that's a thing. Leave that out. Focus on what you love about this person. You could, because here's another thing. Everybody ain't forever. I mean, I don't want to be that guy for y'all, but some people were just for a lesson. Some people were just for, like, you feel me? I'm just saying. Some people was just because, say this. Let's say in my own personal manifestation, I wanted this thing. Let's say this thing was X. So here's my spiritual universe is turning now to guide me towards X. So in my path of X, I meet Y. Y disseminates certain information, whether it's adverse or pro my mission, because it has a diverse effect on me obtaining X. And a lot of people don't realize that that motherfucker was just a stepping stone. That's all that was. Mm-hmm. If you fell, that motherfucker was just a stepping stone, because if you fall, you have to get up. So that was a stepping stone and a learning experience. Now take that with you, because when you get to X, you need this attribute to be prepared, because when you ask for X, you didn't ask the qualifications. You just said, yo, I want the Bentley. You didn't ask what qualifies me for a Bentley. You just felt like you should have one. So when you reached adversity before you got to the Bentley, you was tripping. No. This is part of your qualification,
right?
You know, so you know, without the rain, you don't even get roses. You know, every girl want roses, but she don't want no rain. Without the rain, she don't even get. Can't even bring you a rose without it raining. So, you know what I'm saying?
Are y'all listening?
I mean, I hope they tapped in, because I'm telling you, I'm different, and this is about bringing somebody happiness. So when you have a person that thinks and feels this way now, even if you're not there yourself, you can still feel more happiness, because I'm not putting my burdens on top of your burdens. Because I don't even know how your relationship was with your dad. You're still learning to deal with men. It's deeper than what we think. You know what I'm saying? And I don't want to rain on nobody's parade, but let me tell you right now, relationships are bad. Partnerships are good. Find a partnership. Do not get into a relationship. A relationship means, yo, Maddie, I'm insecure of you being out there with your ass out like that. So, like, for real, you need to put some clothes on. What does that even mean? How does that alter your actions day to day anyway? So if you put clothes on, you're going to be a better person? Or it just makes me feel better? No, it makes me feel better. And that's whack as shit. That's whack. That's whack as shit. Because here's the thing. If your ass is out and you ain't shit, that's who you are. Mm-hmm. And not you ain't shit because your ass out, because your ass could be out and you could be a fucking saint. You could literally not have had sex in 20 years. Mm-hmm. People just think what they think because they have limited perception and perspective.
Correct.
You know what I'm saying? I know girls out there. I got a homegirl that told me some shit like, yeah, Los, I ain't had sex in 10 years. I looked at her like, what? 10 years? I'm talking about a beautiful girl. You ain't had no sex in 10 years. She was like, yeah. Like, she was like, one day God was talking to me and God told me to save myself. And I was like, look, I love you, but that wasn't God. But anyway, but go ahead. I'm like, God ain't tell you to do that, but go ahead. You did that. I'm not saying it's not good to do that. It's good to, if you, because I don't know what your ex is. You know, you might be reaching for ex, and your mission might be purity for it, for to get to just an idea. You might come up with a tech idea that's a $1 billion idea, and the only way you got that tech idea is because you was insanely out of your fucking mind and not in no relationships. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? It be like that. You know how sometimes you can't fully focus on your dreams when you got somebody on the other side worrying about everything you do?
That's, yeah. Yeah. But once you got that person that just supports you and pushes you, motivates you, like, it's a whole nother feeling. Like,
be that woman, Maddie. Be that woman to a man, and you gonna make a nigga become a billionaire. Because you already gonna, I mean, I'm pretty sure the nigga already gonna be a millionaire. You know what I'm saying? If it's you. But you gonna motivate a nigga to get billions. And that's what you want to do. Think about this life. Think about this time we have. Do we really have time to be tripping on some shit that ain't show up to your doorstep? If it ain't show up to your doorstep, it ain't your business. If it's on the gram, it's on the gram. Let a nigga have fun on the gram so he won't have to have fun nowhere else. You know what I'm saying? Like, let the leash
to a certain extent. Slow down, Lowe's.
I'm just saying, you can't control people, because if that's the case, then there's something lacking and it's a conversation.
I'm with you. I'm with you about 90. I'm with you about 90%, but
I'm telling you right now, Maddie,
to a certain extent.
Maddie, you got your belongings out, baby. Maddie, it ain't no extent.
But I'm not over here like doing the most. I'm not.
You know what that means? You know what that means?
I'm not in no nigga phase. I'm not doing
it. Hey, I'm about to tell you something that's real. So dig this. A dude could holler at a chick, right? That got a man, right? And a chick will know she ain't gonna ever fuck this nigga. She ain't gonna ever cross the line with this nigga. But she'll get this nigga's number. She'll exchange combos. She'll talk in the DMs back and forth. Sweet, nice, everything. But you know what she knows? She knows her limits. She knows her boundaries. And guess what? She's fine with that. But she ain't fine with her nigga doing that, because she don't know his limits. She don't know his boundaries. And that's what they fear. They fear your limits and your boundaries. So if you don't let me get my shit off, if you don't let me have my limits and my boundaries, but you know you got yours. You know you got that nigga that be hitting you up, hey, beautiful, that, oh, hey, but you ain't gonna give him no play. You just conversation talking, you know, whatever. You might have gave him your number, whatever, one day. You might, I don't know, just sometimes the approach of people. Sometimes, you know, just me being having a little celebrity, even men back me into a corner sometimes for my number. And it's hard for me being a nice person to be like, yo, I don't give my number out. So sometimes I give my number out to people I ain't even want to give it to. I know that happens. But with a woman, she knows how to gauge where a nigga could go, how far she'll let a nigga go. And she's secure in that. But she's not secure with her man doing that with women. And that's a fact, Maddie. And I'm telling you, I've been dealing with women for 39 years of my fucking life. I came out of a woman. I know how that is. And that's not fair. You have to, if you can be up there and be beautiful, bold, natural, almost nude, and you know what you're doing with that. You know how to deal with that. Let somebody deal with what they're dealing with. It's just, I feel like it's absurd to project that insecurity and draw lines for them. Because if they cross that line, it's a conversation that needs to be had anyway. And that conversation is about happiness. Because like, all right, if I got to go dive in these bitches' DMs and go fuck these bitches, what is it that I truly desire? Am I a one-woman man? Or am I more polygynous? Am I more into polygyny? Am I in the wrong relationship? It ain't never a reflection of you. It's a reflection of that person. What does he really want? Maybe he don't really just want to be with one woman. And you got to respect that. And either you want to share that or you don't want to share that. And you like, nah, I only want a man that want one woman. Then cool. On to the next one. But for you to put those ropes and restraints, you're just going to have more turmoil in building. Because you may not even get to that point if the other hindrances come in the middle and y'all can't even find just social happiness. Like, I like to talk to you. I like to build you. I like to just lay in the dark and just talk with you. When does that ever happen if we beefing about the gram? When is we doing deep shit? When is we on the beach at night, like sneaking on the beach at night, lighting a little fire and just staring into each other's eyes, talking about the fucking stars? Like, that is not happening, Maddie, because it's too many frivolous things taking place. Not enough spontaneous, like, you know, like, suck my dick at Whole Foods. I won't have to talk to a bitch. Where we going? What aisle are we going in? We going to the bathroom? What we doing real quick? Like, just be spontaneous. Be, like, ask a nigga, like, what is it? Okay, you liking all these pictures. What is it that you really want? You like, what is it? Have a conversation. Let that nigga open up his mind instead of wondering and thinking too much. And now you make one day you got a little attitude because you saw something and he don't even know what you was mad at. He like, why are you mad? And you like, nigga, whatever. And then it's now it's a thing. And you, and it's ridiculous. It's silly. We too grown. We too grown to not just be happy. I swear, so many people hate us. So many people don't want us to be successful. For us not to be in a relationship and just make it all happiness is weird at this point. I don't know. That's my Dr. Phil for the day. We could do this. We need to do this more often, because I promise you, I'm not saying nothing toxic, or I'm not leaning on men's side or women's side. This is just a human thing. I think in nature, we wasn't meant to put our veils of constructs over one another. I think, and I could be totally wrong, but I think we was meant to procreate throughout the entire world. Mm. That's what I think we were meant to do. Mm. I think that's what, like, do you realize how divided we are as, like, just humanity? We're like, we'll never be together. We'll always be enemies of something, you know? And I feel like if we were intertwined more, if there was more love that we could give, if it wasn't so limited, you know, I feel like it would be different. And I don't think it would be a sex thing. I think we need to stop attaching sex to everything.
Correct.
Everything totally is not about sex. Liking the picture because it asses out, it's not always a sex thing. It's not always about sex. It's not like that. I know that sex is all we see, but it ain't always about sex. That's just like saying every time you post a picture, it's about sex.
Right.
It ain't about sex. And I know you, but if I just showed your picture to the random person sitting beside me somewhere and asked them, they would probably judge you falsely. And I feel like, first of all, if you're judging any other person, then you got way too much time. You got way too much time, because I guarantee you can look in the mirror and find something.
And
I guarantee you.
Talk to him.
Hey, yo, let me tell you this ritual thing that my girl found that she be doing. And it's like spooky as fuck, but everybody should try it. But look it up, because I don't want nobody to do it wrong and then come back to me and my DMs firing me up. But it's this ritual thing you do where you look in the mirror at yourself. And you look at yourself for a long period of time, right? And I haven't done it because I already know it's kind of creepy. But it says it reveals a lot of things. I think you got to look at yourself for, like, I think like 10 or 15 minutes, like in the mirror, and you break down crying, all types of shit. It's like, but it's called a spiritual cleansing. It's like cleansing. If anybody knows about it, can anybody
speak on it? Mirror gazing?
Mirror gazing. Mirror gazing, Maddie. It's a thing. It's a thing. Is that true? Takar, what's up? Takar says it's true. You've done it, Takar. Yes, she says, yes. See what I'm saying? We haven't even began to look at ourselves. We cannot look at nobody and do that. Mm-mm. Look at yourself. Look in that mirror first. Get the tears up out. Yeah. I might do it tonight and cry.
You let me know how it goes, and then I'll go ahead and do it.
I know I'm gonna cry, because, nigga, my life been crazy as hell. And, you know, you mask so much shit just trying to make it and trying to fake it and just keep moving. The minute you look at yourself and be like, oh, I've been through everything. Ah, you're just going to cry.
I mean, I've had my moments, but I never, like.
Right. Imagine if you just looked into your eyes and you saw your strengths and you realized what you really overcame. It would be overwhelming. Like 15 minutes of looking into your own eyes.
Takar, how often do you do it?
And Takara is a foxy lady.
Mm-hmm.
She's a foxy woman. Hey, but also, y'all, sun gazing is another thing I would recommend for everybody in here. Takara, what do you know about sun gazing? Sun gazing is deep. It's deep. It's deep. Every person of color, I know it's probably some white people in here, don't get mad. But every person of color needs to be sun gazing. I know white people, y'all don't work too well with the sun, but black people, sun gaze, because a scientific fact about our bodies is we are vitamin D deficient. And our main source of vitamin D is the sun, and a lack of that causes depression. So right now, all this social distancing and quarantine is not healthy for black people. We have to get out and get sun. Mm-hmm. Without sunlight, we're under artificial light. We're in these artificial walls that we call homes, and we're not in the elements getting nature. Get some fucking nature. Get some air. Go outside, jog around the fucking block. Breathe in, get some oxygen, and sit in the sun for about 30 minutes. I know y'all see my motherfucking skin.
Hello.
Sit in that sun and bake up for a minute and let your whole body bake up, because your skin is like solar panels, and you have something called melanocytes that transmutes sunlight into your melanin. Activate your melanin. All right? You dig me?
Thank you,
so I've been sun gazing in this deep, yo, and that's why I'm getting a lot of these epiphanies and the shit that I be saying. Like, I never read no books. I don't study. This is just from my heart, and it's like I'm pulling information in through the sun. I'm pulling information in. You know how they say ain't nothing new under the sun?
Uh-huh.
The sun got all the information. The sun been providing energy and life for this planet since it existed.
This person said sun gazing is very powerful, and it feels like the energy is coming into you as you gaze.
It is coming into you. It's coming in through your eyes directly into your brain because it's sunlight. It's going directly into you. Directly into you. But here's the thing. Please study how to sun gaze so y'all don't go out there and fuck y'all eyes up. I know y'all going to go out there.
Please don't look directly at the sun, y'all.
No. You can look directly, but it's only a certain time you can do it. You can only do it at sunrise until 45 minutes. And after 45 minutes, after sunrise, you can't do it. And then only 45 minutes before sunset. So if the sun sets at 8:45, you can start sun gazing at 8 o'clock. But only in that span of time, because the UV rays are too powerful any other way.
Well, I learned something new today.
Bill Nye the Science Guy.
Sunrise and sunset, sun gaze and mirror gazing.
We're gonna try to get Maddie to go a week vegan with me. 1 week vegan challenge. Maddie, what's up? You down? 1 week vegan challenge. You come over here. I'm gonna show you how to cook vegan food. We could document it. We can make content. We could do it for YouTube, the gram. I'm gonna show you how to make meals. I got juicers, all that shit. Show you how to get your blend up, make shit. I'm telling you, once I get you on that regimen, I promise you, you're going. I promise you.
Los, I'm Haitian. Do you know how hard this is going to be?
No, because you know what also, what you have as a Haitian? You have black magic. But are you accessing the black magic? Because you sacrificing animals, but you eating them.
Hello.
Yeah, for my Haitians. Hey, that's what I'm saying. Like, they knew about animal sacrifice, but it was ritualistic. Mm-hmm. And you doing somebody else's rituals. I'm just saying.
Let that sink in.
We could sacrifice a chicken, but you gonna have to get us all this bread, get us right.
Oh,
I ain't eating
God.
It. I ain't putting the dead frequency in me.
Vegan food?
Ugh. Man, I'm talking about, first of all, my mama that walked past, okay, she's a vegan chef. So play crazy. She didn't cook for everybody. She didn't cook for everybody. Mm. All of them. She cooked for Jay-Z and Beyonce's parties, the Kardashians, Blac Chyna, Tyga, all them, like her food is out of this world. And she can make regular shit too, but since we went on this journey, she been going crazy experimenting. Yo, alkaline vegan apple pie, Maddie. Can you imagine eating a whole apple pie and not getting fat?
Thank you, Takara. That sounds great for one.
Yo, alkaline though. I'm talking about alkaline apple pie.
And your mom made it?
What? Yes.
Okay.
Like, I came home one day and she was like, I experimented and tried something. I'm like, what you make? Because, you know, my mama from the hood. She from the old school. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? We from fried chicken and all that. We from that. So I'm always looking at my mom like, what you do? What you just try to slip in my food? Because, you know, I went vegan. Like, my mom ain't go vegan, but she went basically pescatarian.
Okay. I can do pescatarian. That can be a start for me.
Yeah, but the 1 week vegan challenge is just a challenge. It's not like you have to go vegan. You just have to do it for a week. Okay. And look, every time you tell yourself no, your subconscious is conscious of your conscious. So don't tell yourself no. Be like, man, I could do that. 7 days ain't shit. Even if you're lying, don't fucking say you can't. I know you could do 7 days, though, Maddie. I seen you lift up cars. Of course, that's just it. I'm just exaggerating, but, like, you strong, man. Like, come on. You can't do 7 days, man.
I can do it. I'll try.
Man, nigga, we could do a 7-day water fast. I know you could do 7 days vegan.
Oh, yeah. Water is... That's all I drink is water.
You feel me? Like, we could do a 7-day water... We could do a 7-day vegan challenge and then do the 7-day water fast.
Okay. I can do that.
You know what I'm saying? Like, let's do shit in this time of...
The water is easy for me because I drink water... all day long.
All right, so that's gonna be the challenge for me. Even though I drink water all day, hold on, let me show you my water flex. I don't want a water flex on you, but hold up. Let me show you the water flex. Oh God. Oh God. Hold up. This only half of my water, nigga. I spent bands on water. So look at this. Hold on, listen.
That's glass. Good water.
That's what? Only the best water. It's only the best water. And I got even more of that downstairs in the garage. Nigga, stocked up. Nigga, spend bands on water. Like, my greatest thing I buy is water. That's my greatest thing. And I drink a gallon a day. I got cayenne pepper in here, so it looks dark. Mm-hmm. But I got lime and cayenne in this one. And y'all see how far I am through this one for the day. So I'm about to down that, fill it back up.
They want to know what kind of water is that.
That's Mountain Valley. It has a 7.8 pH, which is potential hydration. And, it's naturally alkaline. Anything over 7 is naturally alkaline. No additives. Never drink spring water that says purified. Mm-hmm. Never drink that. This is natural from the earth. So, yeah, I got that. And Mountain Valley is good. You can order that shit online. They bring the drums to your crib just like that. They deliver that shit at your door. And they give you the little machine so you can turn it upside down and mm-hmm. use it and have it in the house. And you can fill up your water bottle every day.
Mountain Valley is great.
Yeah, Mountain Valley is great. It's one of the better waters. So 7.8, that's a great water. That's a great, great water. Most shit you drinking, Dasani is trash. Deer Park is trash. Anything in plastic.
How do you feel about Essentia?
Essentia is trash. It's purified water, baby. That you might as well go get that out your sink, baby. That's pure. Look on it. Read it. Read where it say purified water, then show the people. Ooh, purified water. Purified. You know what purified is, Maddie? That's sink water, baby. Mm-hmm. That's sink water. Filtered. That's filtered tap water you're drinking.
So you don't like, what you call it either.
Fiji? Why not purified? Because purified means water is a cycle, right? So water goes through a filtration process. So when you flush the toilet, it eventually ends up back into the water system. And it goes through a filtration process where they put chemicals in the water to cleanse the water. So any purified water has chemicals in it off the top. And then it's filtered, which takes all the natural minerals out. So like the Essentia she's drinking, it has added minerals. So they added minerals to her purified tap water.
If you're drinking that, put it in the sun, Maddie. What does that mean?
Well, you'll energize your water. Also, Maddie, put lime in it because lime is alkaline and lemon is acidic.
I normally do.
Don't do lemon, though. Don't do lemon. Do lime.
Lime, yeah. I don't really use lemon like that.
So. Yeah, lemons are acidic. They're hybrid.
Okay, those questions.
So this is part of the whole vegan, holistic conversation that gets us into gear. Once we're having these conversations and we're doing, start doing shit, we're not using fluoride toothpastes and
spring water is good too. Trying spring, to read these comments.
Yeah. Spring water is what we're talking about. We're talking about natural spring. That means it came from the ground. The reason why they call it spring is because it comes out of the ground.
Yeah, it's purified water.
So if you're drinking purified water, it can never be spring water.
That's what I was confused about, putting plastic in the sun. That kind of threw me off. That's why.
Yeah, you don't. Maddie, never put plastic in the sun.
What no, she's saying, I know the, that.
But what I'm saying, what she's saying is put the water in the sun. But you got to put the water in a glass container. Mm-hmm. Don't put it the plastic. You got to get a glass jug that you drink your water from.
I kind of figured that. That's why I was a little thrown off. Like, huh?
Right. She missed one step in the instructions. But yeah, the sunlight does something great for your water. But if you just drink spring water, you'll have water that was already in the sun. That's the difference. You don't want a flower that's never been in the sun. You don't even want an animal that's never been in the sun.
Right.
What type of animal is that?
So what made you go vegan? Why did you decide what?
Yeah. I've always been in a constant pursuit of something more. I've never always had my finger on it, and I love that because it keeps me chasing, you know? I've never had it all figured out. Like, I've always been like, what's over there? Then I get over there and be like, what's over there? So I've always been that guy. And one day I was studying. I studied biochemistry, pathology, geography, cosmology, ancient cosmology, ancient African history. I was like studying, like been studying at my old crib. And I got hooked on it. And like 2 months into it, I lost my appetite for meat. And I didn't know why. And remember, mom's a chef. So she going crazy in the crib, cooking it up, all kind of shit. She bring me my food. I'm like, mom, for some reason, I don't want the meat. I don't know why. Maybe I'm just, you know how sometimes you get sick of chicken and you just be like, all right, I'm off chicken for a second. I'm just sick. Maybe you'll switch it up. Maybe you'll have a steak or you'll switch up the meat.
I only feel like that when I go to Haiti because I watch them kill it. So my appetite's all gone.
I couldn't imagine. But yeah, sometimes I would get sick of chicken. Because chicken just started looking disgusting when they start putting all them hormones in it and it'd be all big. And sometimes I'm like, I'm good. I thought it was just that.
Mm-hmm.
And nigga, I ain't never had chicken again, ever. I never could go back. I never could go back and put it in my body once I started my journey of knowledge and understanding that got me to where I am now. I could never go back and eat chicken. And then that spiraled into going full-fledged vegan. So I guess at first I was like a vegetarian for like a week or two when I was figuring out, okay, I'm just eating rice and veggies and I'm going to Bossa Nova and I'm getting not the traditional chicken, but I'm just getting a veggie plate now. All my niggas is getting chicken and I'm looking, I feel kind of left out, but I'm like, I only want these veggies. I take all this asparagus and all this shit grilled up and good. And I just got hooked on that shit. And I met this nigga and he showed me how to change my kitchen up and get the foods that I needed. And then I met Polite, and Polite introduced me to Dr. Sabi.
Mm-hmm.
And I got the herbs from Dr. Sabi. I spent maybe like $500 at the time. I got these herbs and...
Not how much I spent when this was many years ago, but continue.
I've never even looked the same. I don't even look like the same person. You want to know what's funny? I'm going to send you a picture from like around the time when we first met.
Mm-hmm.
Bro, you would think it was like my evil cousin or something. Like
I don't know. I met like 2012, I think.
Yeah, so I can show you a picture from like 2014, 2015. It would fuck your whole head up. Like, what the hell? I look so different.
So you don't smoke anymore?
Nah, I don't smoke. But I've only not been smoking for like 9 months.
Okay.
I ain't gonna front like I had mad years of not smoking. Smoking is beautiful. But I don't drink and I don't do no drugs. But, you know, every once in a while I get back into smoking. But I've been like 9 months right now, maybe a year, no smoking. So, yeah, but I don't think smoking does anything. I mean, smoking doesn't do anything negative to your body.
Mm-hmm.
Unless you're smoking in harsh-ass shit. Like, if you're smoking hella backwoods, it could take a toll. My life's
going to end in a minute, but continue.
If you smoke a hella backwards, it could take a toll. But you smoking in like raw hemp papers and you just being hella hippie with your shit, like Wiz. Wiz looks great. Look at Wiz. He smokes more than everybody. That nigga has flawless skin. He's always happy.
Mm-hmm.
I'm on my way to flawless skin. I don't think y'all see me. Hold on.
I'm getting the light. Getting the light, bro.
Oh, let me get in the light. Ooh. You know what I'm saying? I'm letting my soul glow.
You are almost fully gray.
Yeah, I've been this way for a long time, man. You should
when
see
I met it. You, you were salt and pepper.
I've been like that since I was 14. Mm-hmm. Cause see, my granddaddy,